He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. And He shall cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes you shall look and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near you, near your dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. In their hands shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra. The young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. Because He has set His love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Ginoong Diyos, huwag langit nun niya mahal. During these times of pestilence, during these times of health crisis, economically, Lord, yeah, it really affects all the mankind in this earth, and especially as Christians, your sons and daughters, we are not exempted. But Lord God, we trust in You. We believe in You. Because You are our refuge. And this morning, Lord God, it's my prayer that in the name of Jesus, Your Holy Spirit will going to inspire us and strengthen us. And in the presence of this Philadelphia, of this brethren, we are going to become stronger together, O God. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Pagawas mga kaisunan sa unang deposed niyo sa iyong visiting order na bilang pag-amod dito sa Section 4. Ha? Daghang nataranta, nabalakang nagoon. And even the ministers and the rest of the Christian community are being alarmed. Ganoon na yung mga magutbol, kumikrap mga or meaning, nakuha na tayong kagawasan. Nailaw na tayo sa martial law. And then, ako pong minaconsider nga as a Christians, during times of crisis, either good or bad ang nasa pamunuan, I do believe our sole focus, duties, and responsibility as Christian is to put our faith, our trust in God. And especially, to pray for those who are in authority and to submit to those people who are in authority. For me, I do believe ang ginagawa niyo is just a simple way and means of solving our crisis. Pinagi sa inyong sitting order to meet the herd immunity. To some ministers and to some Christians, yung sanunsan na istorya, asa na nga itong pagsaling? Pabatay pa ito, pagsaling sa Ginoo, that everything, that God is a sovereign God, and everything is under His control. No? Muna na, kung naman akong mga kaisunan, it's a reminder for us all, no? Nga, let us not add up the stress and the burden of our government leaders, because I do believe they are thinking for the betterment of the masses sa kadaghanan dito. And our sole responsibility as Christians is to submit, no? And to pray. That's why sa iyang emergency meeting nga kitang tambungan sa Waxibo with Ma'am Gobernador Juan Garcia o tanang mga mayor sa Waxibo, nanawakan siya sa tanang ukunganon nga makaupo. And this is our best expertise as Christian. Our best part na ating ka-contribute is to pray. Dili na ta mudugang pa ng daghang mga istorya nga magapa add up lang sa iyang ipangunana. And at the same time, kung if it is as what you think nga anti-Christ na, okay, mamukulit, mamukay, panapot na itong kagagahanan niya, di na magunta kapalit, di na punta kapalit niya kung ito'y vaccination, walay card niya pagkita. And so be it. Kaya kung nung sabay mong tuhuan, mamukulay mga lifestyle na. But I would like to remind you, we cannot stop the Antichrist from reigning on this earth. So as the Antichrist cannot stop when Jesus is going to come and reign and establish his millennial reign. Amen. So sa di ba na ibuhat ko ni Christ Jesus, magunang magung yawa? Di natin na magungan. Ang importante natin yan yung mga isunan, we must know our God. And whatever happened, kung mag-inonsra, inigmata na ito, langit na. Kesa mag-add up at burden sa itong kabalingong kinabuhi. Maghatag patag kadugang kahasol. May usahay at itong kabalingong mo itong disun-disunod. Di ba ba pwede kung maugin ang ipatuman? Ang advice na ito, kay stay at home naman yun. Di na kita kagawas. Amadugo, lalataglaan, nga mo'y mamalik. Diba? Ang nga problema lang, kaya kung matalay yun naman, ako na ng Antichrist, hindi kita magpapasin. But anyway, it's a reminder for us all. You must know your God, and that your God, nga atong ginalagara, is a sovereign God. Amen? Di siya makuratan nining mga nag-graduate na karon sa linya sa mga kapastoran almost every week. Na ay mga goodbye Philippines. And most of these ministers, when I was the regional director sa Moral Recovery Program, ako rin silang na-meet personally. And they're good ministers, they're good pastors. So, nangapata din eh, let us keep on living and do the business of God, the Father, i-trust na ato kang Christ Jesus, kung niya ito niya mga sa masunod ni Christ Jesus, mo'ko din atong parabuhato. This should be our sole purpose. Our passion to God and our compassion to people. As Christian mga iksoon, let us always be reminded that God is our refuge. Ato na diskubri atin ni mga iksoon na that one of the most comforting chapter din sa Biblia at mga kaplaga din sa Salmo 91 naga-describe din ni sa siguridad sa mga magtutuo na atong posible i-enjoy kung musalik ta kung mo na kung talagpanan ang Ginoo, ano na yung benefits nini diri sa tuwa. Christians can especially benefit from the set of promises. So there are, I've seen, 6 promises on this chapter. And Christian benefits. Number 1, in verse 1 and 2, he who dwells in the presence, in the secret place of the Most High, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 2, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. First promise in this chapter is God's presence. Kung makinabuhi ta na Kristohanon na kanunay na pabilin sa iyong presensya, if you remember an experience of living in the mountain of God experience, and this is referring to our personal prayer life, our personal Bible reading, our devotion, and especially our intercession with God. This is not just merely attending a Sunday service, niya usahay taga-Domingo ra punta mga sinating presensya sa Ginoo. Niya usahay iksimba paginato kay ang ato mga mata mga pahinantay man usahay niyo taga wala akong mag-bless. Kaya naman, we're fixing our eyes not on Jesus but on people. It's a problem with the heart. So, make this your firm commitment and decision that you need to fix your eyes on Jesus. Araw na mo na experience kanunay ang presensya sa Ginoo. It has our responsibility nga mo choose yuta dinha sa iyang presensya. Modi ang iyang promise o kaginipisyo nini as Christian. It doesn't have to be lonely. Sa itong pagkinabuhin Kristohanon, when we do a very drastic, some drastic decision na unpopular sa kanaghanan, daghang mga tao na di ganahan na ito, dili mo yun na ito, musupar na ito, mukritisize, mukumitog, dili maayos na ito. But when you know that God is your refuge, niya nakakanunay siya presensya, dili ka mag-uol. Amen. So di ata ka mga eksonan. Bisang pagkatibo kalibutan, ang pumili na sa tuwa sa importante, nahibaw ka ang Ginoo, you dawat ka kung ka, and you're pleasing God. That's what really matters most. Amen?